This time it's gonna be I Forgot Where We Were by Ben Howard. But before I teach you this next song, I'd like to talk quickly about a record label called Vulu. Vulu Records is a company I'm working with that helps unknown artists get found and even paid for their YouTube videos. So if you are an unknown artist watching this right now, I highly recommend checking them out. You won't regret it. I've provided a link in the description box that leads you right there. So just check them out, sorry. The song now, I Forgot Where We Were by Ben Howard, is played in an open tuning, as usually, almost any song by Ben Howard. Played on an electric guitar. What you need is a little bit of delay. That's what Ben Howard puts in his live performances. So, the tuning of your guitar, as far as I could find out, and it sounds good to me, is D, A, D, G, G, D, from low to high. So it's in D, A, D, G, G again, and D. Alright, the song is not that hard concerning the structure. Consists of an intro, which is almost like the verse part, a little bridge, and the chorus part, but both aren't that difficult to play. So the most difficult part of the song is basically the intro and the verse part, where Ben Howard plays over his neck. I'm gonna teach you this now. Let's get started. Good, the intro part, and actually the verse part as well, starts with your index finger on 3rd fret, low 2 strings. Okay? That's the first you need to know. Oh my god, sorry. And your ring finger on 2nd fret, 2nd string, and maybe 3rd string as well. They're both in the same tuning, both tuned down to G. So, doesn't matter if you hit one or both. The first thing your right hand does is an open strum. The low 3 strings. Then you put down your index finger, low 2 strings, 3rd fret. Strum it. Two strums, low two or low three strings. Then put your ring finger on 2nd fret, 2nd and 3rd string. And then you do a strum where you hit the high 3 or 4 strings. So far, then you put your pinky on the 2nd fret, low 2 strings, and do a slide up from 2nd to 4th, within one stride of your right hand. And then you put your index finger on 7th fret, low 2 strings. And you got the same two strides on the low 3 strings. And then you put your ring finger on the 5th fret, 2nd and 3rd string. Strides on the high notes, and now you put your pinky on 5th fret, low 2 strings, and after one hit you put your index finger on the 10th fret, low 2 strings. two strides again on the low three strings. And now there starts the variation part, the part which he changes during a lot of performances and during the intro and the verse part. When you're on the low two strings on 10th fret, then you use your middle finger on the second string, 9th and 10th fret, to do a slide up and slide down from 9 to 10 and back to 9. And now in the intro part, there is the pinky on the 7th fret, 2nd string. Right? And when you get that so far, you change the position of your index and your middle finger and put it on your middle finger, put your middle finger on 9th fret 6th string and your index finger on 10th fret 5th string. Two or three strikes on the low bass notes, and then you've got a harmonic which is played on 7th fret with your ring finger. For those of you who don't know what harmonics are, you hit the strings, you touch the strings exactly above the fret wire of the 7th fret, right here. And pay attention that you really just slightly touch the strings. You're not holding them down. You're just touching them slightly and striking with your right hand. That gives it this harmonic sound. So that's what Ben Howard does up here with his ring finger. Right? And then the whole thing starts from the beginning. He stops here. He plays the same thing again from the beginning until he's on 7th and 5th fret, and then he does a slide down. What that means is he has his index finger on 7th fret low 2 strings and his middle finger on the 2nd and 3rd string 5th fret, and then he strikes them all. And he does a slide down with his index finger from 7th to 5th fret and with his ring finger from 5th to 4th fret. Alright? And that's where the verse starts. The verse part is actually the same like the intro part, just some little variations up here. So you start on 3rd fret again, same like in the intro, but when you're up here on the 10th fret, you're not playing. You're leaving out the pinky on the 7th fret, and you're leaving out the harmonics on 7th fret, and you're not doing the slide up, slide down as well. At least sometimes you're not doing that. Ben Howard varies a little bit in here. most of the time he's playing 10th fret low 2 strings, middle finger on 2nd string 10th fret, and then sliding down to 9th. Changing the position with middle finger 9th fret 6th string and index finger 10th fret 5th string like before, and just playing until the end without the harmonic part, and then starting from the beginning. Sometimes he plays plays 10th fret low 2 strings, then puts his middle finger on 9th fret, plays 2 or 3 strums, and does the slide up slide down thing you learned in the intro part, and then goes back to that shape and plays it till end. So yeah, some little variations in here. What else? Is there anything else I can tell you about that? I don't think so. So, he never plays the harmonic part in the verse, and usually he's not doing the slide up, slide down thing. What he plays most of the time is middle finger on 2nd string 10th fret, playing 2 or 3 strides, and then moving down to 9th fret 2nd string. Basically, the verse. Nothing more to say about it. Oh yeah, one thing. The last time he plays the verse thing here, when he's on the 7th fret and 5th fret, like in the intro, he does the slide down thing, like at the end of the intro, and then he goes into the chorus part, which I'm going to show you now. To the chorus part, which starts on 3rd fret 6th string. Hello love. This is the part where he sings "Hello love, my invincible friend." So he starts on the 3rd fret, 2nd string, and just strumming the 6th string, moves up to 10th fret, 6th string, then down to 9th fret, 6th string, up to 15th fret, 6th string, and then back to 10th fret, up to 14th, then 15th, back to 10th fret, 9th fret, 3rd fret. So once again, hello love, my invincible friend, hello love, this is in the bird, hello love, for you. Yeah, 3, 10, 9, 15, 10, 14, 15, 10, 9, 3. So that's basically the chorus part. And then he's stays on the third fret. But I forget where we were in forget where we were. What he's doing here is he's playing on the 3rd fret, 6th string. Strumming 6, 5 and 4. What you should pay attention on is that you mute the 5th string with your index finger or your middle finger, whatever you use, and then you strum. And then it goes up to 7th fret, down to 5th fret, and back to 3rd fret. And repeats that over and over again, until he starts again with the verse part. There's a little gap in between the chorus and the next verse, where he plays like the same thing like in the intro with where he plays the same thing like in the intro with the pinky on 7th fret and the harmonic on 7th fret. So the chorus, then this little gap where he plays the intro again at the next verse. And then again a chorus, and after the second chorus he stays on the 3rd fret. That was wrong. He stays on the 3rd fret, starts strumming. And then he strums 7, 5th, 10th, and 9th, stays on the 9th fret, and begins again with 7, 5, 10, 15. When he is on the 3rd fret after the second chorus, stays on the 3rd fret, playing louder and louder, strumming more of the strings, and then he starts. Gets back into the intro part. Well, and the rest of the song is playing the verse part again until he gets to that slide down. And if you want to play that like you hear it in the live versions, you have to play it twice. Where the song ends. Alright guys, thanks for watching, thanks for tuning in. I hope I could help. If there are any questions, just write me a message or write a comment in the comment section below. Have fun learning the song, it's a cool tune to play. Cheers guys, see you soon.